What's up, everybody? You're watching Suburban Underground Television, Georgia State University. I am DJ Stereotype, and I'm sitting here with the director of the new movie Black Snake Moan and also the director of Hustle and Flow, Craig Brewer. How are you?
I'm doing good. How you doing?
Excellent, excellent. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you as well. So basically, you know, a lot of the movie is based on, I think, perception and a lot of how, like, the indiscretions of our actions and whatnot get the best of us and how it clouds our perception of ourselves as well as other people.
Very, very perceptive.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I wanted to do something about perception with you. You know, so we're going to do a little writing exercise really, really quick. There's your pen.
Oh, Lord.
Do you know what a haiku is?
Oh, is that, wait a minute, no, that's a poem, right?
Yeah, it's a poem. It's got a 5-7-5 line. So the first line is 5 syllables.
Right.
The second line is 7, and then the third line is 5.
Right.
So really quickly, we have 30 seconds.
To write a haiku?
To write a haiku about Black Snake Moan.
Shit. Oh, and it's 5 syllables, right?
5 syllables the first line, 7 syllables the second line, 5 syllables the third line.
Okay, man.
And it doesn't have to rhyme.
About Black Snake Moan.
Yes. Or your perception of me when I walked in, if that's easier.
My perception of you when I walked in? I gotta write a haiku about that?
Yeah. Yeah, that's more interesting. Let's do that.
About you?
Amen.
Well, I don't really know you all that well.
But it's your perception. Exactly. So you don't know me, it's your perception.
Okay.
Okay, you count for 30 seconds. Starting now. Damn.
Time's up.
Alright, I only got 2 lines.
I only got 2 lines, too.
Alright.
I'll go first?
Yeah, you go first.
I only got 2 lines. Energy untamed, provocateur. that's only 6.
That's cool.
Alright, you?
Rustic creative. Syllables are not coming.
You nailed on me. Goddamn, man. I'm
sorry.
Trying to get that.
You did good. No, you did good. No, you did good. All right, so basically.
I like Energy Untamed. I thought
Energy Untamed was hot.
If you got to get a tat, you know, that's what you should get. Like, Energy Untamed.
All right,
you
know? That's what's up. We'll
like,
do
with
that.
Somebody, like, you know, break the chain. You know?
Like, me breaking the chain from Samuel
Jackson. Man, I'm pretty proud of mom.
You did good. You need to publish that. You need to publish that. All right. So get into the movie. Basically, this is kind of centered more or less around the blues.
Right.
And Hustle and Flow is more about hip-hop.
Right.
I really liked how you personified the musical aspect through, like, the people's actions. Can you tell me a little bit more about how you went about doing that?
It's hard because, you know, the first thing you want to do when you're making movies is you think about story and you think about, like, these images. But for me, it really starts with music and it really starts with that energy.
Right.
And I feel like if you can mainline into the tone of a particular music, then it'll inform the story, it'll inform the imagery. So, like, when I was just driving around in my city listening to 8-Ball and NJG and 3-6 Mafia and Al Capone and all those guys, I felt Hustle and Flow.
Right.
I felt like, you know, this is a music that is infectious, and it's also available to anybody. It's not a privileged art. You know,
right.
You don't have to like be some sort of musical scholar or something like that to do rap. Sometimes you can just take like a little bit from like Halloween, the horror movie, and you can sample that and put a beat to it, and you flow over it, and art happens. You know?
Definitely.
So. That was the spirit that I really wanted for Hustle and Flow.
Right.
The lowest of the low is entitled to be creative. And
right.
I feel like the biggest sin that to do on another person is to take away their voice.
Right.
You know, I mean, you can take away their freedom. You can put them in jail. You can hurt them. But to take away their muse or to take away you know, their creative spark, I think is really soulless. You know?
Right.
But with Black Snake Moan, you know, if you're gonna, I began to experience the blues myself. And they say sometimes music finds you.
Right.
You know, that sometimes you may, you know, you listen to something and it may not register with you, but then maybe you get married, you have a kid, and you, or you experience death, and you're like, man, I really love Merle Haggard.
It becomes
I didn't think I'd like country music that plays one song, but man, now I'm just feeling it.
That's how it is for me. I mean, like, as a student, being relatively young and everything, there's so many things that I have knowledge of that I don't really understand yet.
Right.
And, but the more you live, the more you understand your knowledge. Like,
and it also requires a great amount of patience, but also you got to kind of not be so judgmental.
Right.
And I think, you know, when you start off, you know, living your life and you know, being young and being creative, the first thing we want to do is, like, you know, piss around our territory.
Right.
The first thing we want to do is, like, man, you don't know what you're talking about.
Right.
I know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, my shit is high.
Right. And that's and that's the first time that you begin to kind of, like, branch out on your own, and you're kind of like Magellan, you know, you're going across that ocean. But then you get knocked in the gut, and then you get the carpet pulled out from under you, and you're like, well, wait a minute. When I was 18, this didn't hurt so bad, but it's hurting a little bit more, and, like, I'm beginning to not think that I'm so confident anymore.
Right.
That's, to me, like, what I wanted to explore with Black Snake, where there's all of these, you know, Southern archetypes coming together, and there's this, people, when they see Sam Jackson's character and Christina Ricci's character in that house, you know, he's so big and so old and so black, and she's so small and so white and so young. They're both terrified and titillated, like, at the same time. And I really wanted to go through this journey where, by the end of it, you kind of feel stupid about it all.
Like, I loved how the imagery plays on unconscious things that people are not comfortable with. Just the image of, like, Christina Ricci, like, putting her toe on this old black, you know what I'm saying?
It's like, there's,
like, things like that.
You're just like, oh,
no, don't do that. You know, exactly.
There's this one part in the movie, real quick, where she's in a fever. And she's, like, unconscious. I mean, she's not even, you know, in control of herself. And she lunges forward and kisses him.
Right.
And the whole audience just flinches, like she's an alien, out of his gut, you know?
And
he goes,
oh! Well, it's so funny because...
Away, 'cause no one out there listens to a single word.